Jesus says, I am the truth, I am the life, and I am the way. Nobody comes to the Father except through me. There is no back door to Jesus. There is no back door. There's not many ways to Jesus. There's only one way to Jesus. Only one way to Jesus. God the Father, amen. Am I right about it? Amen. You know what? This world right now that we're living in is a big prison for us. It's putting everybody down. It's a big prison cell. And we are all on death row. We are all on death row. Everybody's on death row. In this prison that we live in right now. You are being held hostage by Satan because you are in the house empty. Where is your house empty? Where is your house? Scripture says that your house is the holy temple of the Lord. And you left your holy temple, your house empty. I'm not talking about your house on the street where you live. I'm talking about your house, your possessions. Amen. You got it empty. Scripture says that when you leave your house empty, you give Satan an opportunity to come in. You give Satan an opportunity to come in. Scripture also said that once that demon leaves, that demon goes into dry places. Because a demon hates not having a body. Because hell is that bad. Hell is that bad. The demon wants a body to inhabit. And they know he's here. They know he's a easy target, do they not? Yeah, they know he's a easy target. And if your house is stripped in the water, they're going to inhabit the house. And you're going to be in a worse state than you were before. You're going to be in a worse state than you were before. Amen. So take heed. You got to stand strong and say no. You think the world will test me. God says, repent. For the kingdom of God is at hand. But notice how he put that word in there. See, people want eternal life. That's why that movie Peter Pan is so popular. But this is real talk. You can have eternal life. This ain't no movie. This is real talk. You can have eternal life with Christ Jesus, but first you have to repent. See, at first it sounds different. Oh, really? You mean I can live forever with Jesus and not have to face the decimation of the crooked nation and go to the lake of fire? Good. And then I tell him, you have to repent and turn your back to the world. And then you say, oh, wow, okay. All right. I see you. Bye. They walk away from their salvation. because of this man that wanted to stay and wanted to know what to do to be saved. So he thought he was following Jesus. And he was following Jesus, so he was asking what to do to be saved. And he got kind of close to it. What must I do to be saved? He wanted to be saved. I wish somebody would come to us right now like that sick man who went to Jesus. What would a different outcome than this one? Jesus said, give up everything you have, sell everything you have to the poor, and follow me. And all of a sudden, this man smiled, and he was frightened, coming to a fire, and he was waiting. He walked away, but guess what? He walked away from the very first place then. Because you wanted everything in this world, everything that he had in this world, as if it really meant anything. As if it really meant anything. Let me tell you something. Everything in this world is temporary. Your car is temporary. Your house is temporary. Your kids, your husband, your wife, and your friends is all temporary. It's a mere minute. It's going to be gone soon. But Jesus is permanent. Everything you have is temporary, but Jesus is permanent. Scripture says, store not your treasures on this earth, but store up your treasures in heaven. Amen. Why worry about what you have? Let me ask you a question. Has anybody ever seen a letter attached to a new house? Huh? I don't think so. There is no letter attached to you. When you say you can't take anything with you but your soul, and all souls belong to me, saith the Lord. All souls belong to me. From dust you came, to dust you shall return. Amen? But this soul belongs to God the Father, after all. He created it. Did he not create it? Am I right about it? Everything you are. God the Father has made man in our image. Amen? Amen. So don't believe those pastors. Don't believe what you see on YouTube. Don't believe what you see in the media. I saw in my soul with the devil. No, you can't sell something that God made for you. And that belongs to God the Father. That's what Satan has done to be saved to you. So that's where you really have no power. Does Satan have any power? No, he has no power. He really has no power. Amen. He might have a little bit of power when I was walking in the world and living in the world, but I was unwillingly and unwillingly doing the spirit. And I didn't know the word, I didn't even know the word, but when I started sipping the milk and eating the meat, God told me you're going to preach the word until the church is evangelized. No, we're going to preach the word until the word is evangelized and the church is complete. That's my mission every day. Why do I do it? I do it because I. And Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. I love you. And we already know what's going to happen to those who die in their sin. And we want to save our brothers and sisters out here for the same way. Come to save us. God almighty is still singing praises. God almighty is still singing. And while the earth is still here, the goodness of God. Amen? Amen. So make these decisions today because you don't have that much time to go. Amen. Good. I'm going to pack up around the system.
We can tell you all a whole lot about living your life to Jesus because that is the only way you will have life. But I'm going to talk to people that are mad at God. You may feel like God took your loved one. You may feel like God made you lose your house. You may feel like God made you lose your job. I'm going to talk to y'all. Because I know what it's like to be mad at God. God, why did He make this pain for you? God, why did He make this terrible? God, why did He make this? Why did He make this a struggle? I know what it's like to be mad at God. Then how can us be creation question the Creator? God tells us, do not allow your presence and suffering to be compared to the glory that will be revealed to you. Because now you went through a whole lot. I've been through a whole lot. In 23 years, I've been through a whole lot. I was mad at God. God, why me? Now that God sent me. God sent me because I love you. And God loves all of you, and He sent stories that you went through what you went through. He sent stories. And you know what you accept through the Lord? And you know how much pain God went through? When He had to send His blood into the world, and die on the cross, and be beaten, and bitten, and put nails in His hands, put nails in His feet. All because of you, all because of me, because I love living the way I live. So God knew that when He sent His Son into the world to die on the cross and to be raised again, He knew exactly what He was hanging on that cross for. He was hanging on that cross for your anger, for your resentment towards Him. I understand what it feels like to be mad at God. But who am I to question the Creator that put His presence in my life this morning, that gave me the strength to even stand in front of you right now? Because if by my own strength I wouldn't be here. I'd be falling on TikTok, falling on Instagram, out of whoever. But no, Instagram doesn't save you. Those people you're comparing to yourself who don't save you. Your life doesn't even look like that. It's fake. People are fake. They're making it seem like the Lord is all cranked up. The Lord is cranked up. The Lord is to death. The Lord is to death. The Lord is to be by yourself. I know what it means to be by myself, what I thought to be by myself. But God is with me to every step of the way. Y'all know that little post that we like to hang up. Oh, at one time I only seen my first step walking in the sand. No, God is carrying us when we're going through that stuff. You don't have to be strong by yourself. How can you be strong by yourself? Even the strongest people, even myself. I was somebody that didn't want to show me weakness. Because how could I be weak in a world that plays the weak? How could I be weak? How could I say that I'm weak? So I got to pretend like I'm strong. So trust this world. But this world is going to lead me to hell. This world is going to lead you to hell. This world doesn't love you. This world doesn't care about your depression. This world doesn't care about your anxiety. This world doesn't care that you're back on it. This world doesn't care that you're not to be homeless. This world doesn't care that you are homeless. Because I was ever